Good morning, everyone. Nice to greet you here in Otepää, in the winter capital of Estonia. The first start of today's competition, which is middle distance. So the first starts were almost already 5 minutes ago. Today the tracks are a lot shorter than 2 days ago. But I might say it's pretty tricky and pretty technical, so I don't expect them to do them too fast. There's two radio controls on the way, and I will try to share information with you from those two radio controls while the competition is running. And of course, as 2 days ago, we tried to catch some nice words from the best athletes who have just finished their treks. So it's not yet too many people here on the Defendi Stadium, but they will be here soon enough when they have sent all their competitors to the start. But those following us on the live feed, for you, I can already start sharing information once when I have it. So I wish you all an interesting race for the spectators and as well for the competitors. And I'm sure today will be really challenging enough to see who is really the best one. And now that we have the first competitors already in the forest for 13 minutes, we finally have a first racer in the first radio control in Boys One School. It's Anton Hampu from Finland. And from that radio control until the second radio control in this course, it's really a tricky part. So the times in the first radio control don't yet show how they're going to perform in total. But yes, now really soon enough, we will start to have a lot of radio control times from all the classes, which is really exciting. And as well, the race has started in Boys One Selected class, where we have Finlay Johnson from England in the first radio control. And you see a lot of people starting all the time from the screen. You can browse them and you see that the forest is actually pretty thick and full of leaves. So running straight through the forest in these areas is really difficult. If you didn't listen to us 2 days ago, I can remind you that on these very same tracks, there were European Orienteering Championships in 2006. And even the best orienteers of Europe were really struggling in these forests because it is technical, it is really hilly. I think 2 days ago there was just one girl, the girl from New Zealand, who said that it was easy to run these hills. Everybody else said that it was pretty tough on the technical side and on the physical side. It's really, you have to be careful in these forests because it's really easy to injure yourself. And as well, it's really many tracks in here, so it's really interesting for the route choices, whether you try to go straight through the forest or you try to run around or if you should try to avoid some hills. So it really provides you a lot of options to choose from.
Valla. Ben iyiyim.
And we have first finishers. There's, in girls' one school, there's Aino Asklöf from Finland. And at the moment, she still has the best time in the radio control as well. And in Girls One School class, the after the radio control is really easy until the end, easy and short part. So yes, I think not soon anybody will beat her in there. And as well, we have in Girls One selected Laura Fidalgo from Spain in the finish already. So today's the tracks are a lot shorter than 2 days ago. So I think it's going to get really, really, really interesting and exciting here soon to get all the new times in the radio controls and in the finish. And as well in Girls 2 selected, we have a finisher from Latvia, Elise Bremse. You can see on the screen that it's really extremely thick forest. I think many of you are not really jealous of not being there by yourself. I think today going straight through the forest and taking these route choices might be extremely difficult, as it's really easy to get lost and it's really, really extremely slow pace trying to go through these thick green areas. And I can tell you that over the summer it gets even worse and worse and worse. So at the moment it's still kind of doable. But I guess it's really a challenge. And those who are looking at us from your nice warm homes. Well, in here it's almost snowing, slightly raining. I guess it's +3 degrees, whereas 2 weeks ago it was more than 20 degrees warm. So we were really, in a way, lucky to get these interesting weather conditions. But as you know, it's not a big deal for orienteers. They're really used to any weather. And yeah, makes it even more challenging, I suppose. And now that we are having more and more finishers, I have the first finisher from Boys 1 selected class, Finlay Johnson, and I can say that at the moment, Finlay, you still hold the best time in the radio control as well. So it looks like you did quite well today. So how was the terrain? How were the tracks? From the screen, it looks like it's really, really tough to go through the bushes and through the woods. So how was it for you?
Oh, it's just so tough to get through any of that. So I just decided to go around the paths and just give it as hard as I could go. But as soon as you got into that green, you're just slowing down so much.
So did you intentionally try to choose the route choices that go kind of around the woods, or did you try to go straight through them?
Definitely around for most of them, because there weren't many short legs, there was more medium legs, so I just decided to go try and go around, but a few of them definitely go straight for the small ones.
Yeah, I think I would do the same choices today in this, so good luck for the last competition day as well, and thank you.
Yeah, cheers.
And we have our first finisher in boys to school class, and it's Apo Grankvist from Finland. He's at the moment the only finisher, but knowing that he had a really good time 2 days ago as well, so I think this kind of might be the time that that will be the best times in boys to school. So his time is 21 minutes and 10 seconds on the 2.9 kilometer track. And if you've seen what's going on the screen, then you might guess that running even 3 kilometers in these forests is pretty difficult. It's really not like running just on a nice forest path, but it's really tricky and complicated. So, and Apo Grankvist's time is still the best in the radio control as well. So I think he had a nice run today as well. And in girls 2 selected, we have in Finnish Marta Martinez from Spain. And she takes the lead currently, leading by 3 minutes 21 seconds. And as you can see, she holds the best time in the radio control as well. In boys 2 selected, we have a new second best time in radio control. It's Timo Gudra from Estonia. I already saw his sisters waiting here in the Finnish, trying to cheer for him. Well, you can go next. I can see them next to the Finnish corridor, because I think in less than 4 minutes, Timo will be here in the Finnish as well. So those who gave away your maps in the finish, you can go now and get them back. So those people who gave away your orienteering map in the finish area, you can go now back to the finish area and you can get your maps back. And in boys 1 selected, we have a new best time in the first radio control. It's Francesco Mariani from Italy. But I can tell you that between the first radio and the second radio in Boys One Selected, it's really tricky part. So I'm really excited to see how Francesco is doing in the next 10 minutes, because in about next 10 minutes he should be in the second radio. And as well in Boys Two Selected, we have a new best time in the radio control. It's Gustav Stana from Latvia, and he takes the lead by 3 minutes and 42 seconds, so he's really doing a good run at the moment. And we have in the finish as well new best times in Boys 2 Selected. The first currently at the moment is Oliver Calvet from Austria. The second is Timo Gura from Estonia, losing by 38 seconds. But we have a really fast Latvian boy coming from there, and he's passed the radio control by far the best time at the moment. And he should be here in the finish in the less than 5 minutes. So soon we will have a new leader with a really good time in Boys 2 Selected. Just as information from the last radio controls until the end, in every class it's rather easy and rather short part. So it's around, well, I would say it looks kind of like 800 meters, and it's not tough orienteering.
So if you have a good time in the last radio control, then there is not too much that you can mess up after that, just a bit. And it's not too many route choices after that as well. So having a good time in the last radio control indicates a really good race overall from the day. And as well in Boys 1 Selected, we have a new best time in the last radio. It's Axel Lundgren, who did a good run 2 days ago as well. And at the moment, he is leading by 1 minute and 25 seconds ahead of Finlay Johnson in the second radio control. And from there to finish, as I told you, it's a really short way to go. So soon, I think, we'll have a new leader in Boys 1 Selected when Axel is finishing. In Boys 1 School, we have a new best time in the first radio. It's Arvid Aronsson, and he takes the lead by 28 seconds ahead of Anton Hampu, who is the current leader in the finish in this class. And in the meanwhile, we had the fast Latvian boy finishing in Boys 2 Selected, who I told you about. I kind of missed when he finished, but now we have his time. And of course, he took the lead by far in the finish. Gustav Stana from Latvia leading in Boys 2 Selected. And he's ahead of Oliver Calvet by 3 minutes and 50 seconds. So that's a really good time from Gustav Stana. And on the same time, we have in the finish now Axel Lundgren, and of course, taking the lead. The time is 25 minutes and 3 seconds, and he's ahead of Finlay Johnson by 1 minute and 42 seconds.
Are you Axel? Can I have a few words with you?
I found Axel Lundgren right here in the finish corridor. So it looks like you did a really good run today. Is it like that, or was there any struggle for you?
It went pretty good, actually. Not many misses. So, yes.
How was it running-wise? Was it easy to go through the forest? I know the mountains or the hills for the Swedish guys should be really easy, but how was it for the forest-wise?
It was quite tricky. Pretty hard to see far, and yeah, but you can run pretty fast. There was always other alternatives, so yeah.
But congratulations on the good race, and thank you.
Thank you.
And here's a little announcement as well. I've heard that there's a problem that some teams have tried to go back to hotel through the competition area. this is strictly not allowed. So going to your hotel through the competition area is strictly not allowed. So please don't do that. Don't go through the competition area when the competition is still running. And in Boys One Selected now we have a new leader in the finish. It's Francesco Mariani from Italy. If I'm not mistaken, then he was on the podium 3 days ago as well. So Francesco Mariani taking the lead now by far, by leading 1 minute and 47 seconds ahead of Axel Lundgren. And in Boys One School we have a new best time in the first radio. Now that already 17 people have passed the first radio, or even 18. We have a Finnish boy, Atte Ikola, there by taking the lead by 15 seconds ahead of Arvid Aronsson. But as I told you before, it's quite a tricky part coming between the first and second radio controls. So there's still a lot to do for Atte Ikola and Arvid Aronsson before they can approach the finish. And now in Boys One School, Arvid Aronsson reached to the second radio and looks like he managed to do the difficult part in the middle pretty well, because he has the best time in the second radio, going ahead of Anton Hampu by 19 seconds. So Anton Hampu is the one currently holding the best time in the finish. But now in the next 5 minutes, Arvid Aronsson has a chance to beat Anton Hampu if he runs fast and makes no mistakes, because the lead is only 19 seconds. So he has to succeed the last 5 minutes as well in order to be here with the best time. And on the same time, we have a new leader in Girls 2 school. It's Polina Levchenko from Ukraine, taking the lead by 10 seconds ahead of Emily Turner from England. In boys 2 selected, we have a new leader in the finish. It's David Rapotz from Austria. In the radio control, he had a second time, but he was faster than Gustav Stana in the last part. So David Rapotz from Austria took the lead in the finish in boys 2 selected, and he is ahead of Gustav Stana by 23 seconds. And on the same time, we have a new third current place in boys 2 selected. It's Sam Croshaw from England, going behind David Rapotz with 2 minutes and 47 seconds. And in girls 1 selected, we have a new second place in the finish, Siiri Talts from Estonia, going behind Agnija Kauna by 29 seconds. And Siiri Talts currently holds the third time in the first radio as well. But to remind you, in every class there are still really many starters to come. And the last ones starting today are in boys 1 selected class. And no, it's in boys 1 school class, and they go almost 2 p.m. so there's still 2 hours of starts going on in today's competition. And on the same time, we have in the finish in boys 1 selected Matis Saulita from Latvia, taking the second place at the moment behind Francesco Mariani with 1 minute and 13 seconds. And in Girls One Selected, we have a new leader in the finish, Ebba Lindell from Sweden. In Radio Control, she was ahead of the Latvian girl by only 1 second, but I suppose she ran really fast the last 5 minutes, because in the finish, she takes the lead by already 36 seconds ahead of Agnea Kauna. So Ebba Lindell currently takes the lead in Girls One Selected. And as well, a nice news for Swedish people, Arvid Aronsson is in the finish and takes the lead ahead of Anton Hampu by 23 seconds. So indeed, he managed to do a fast last part. But in this class, we have Atte Ikola from Finland approaching the finish soon, and he currently holds the best time in the second Radio Control ahead of Arvid Aronsson by 36 seconds. So really soon, we might have a new leader in Boys One School. In Boys 2 Selected, we have in the Radio Control Aymar Urquiza from Spain and taking the lead. And if I'm not mistaken, then 2 days ago this boy was one of the fastest as well. And at the moment, in first radio, and this is the only radio, he takes the lead by 23 seconds. So soon, in the next less than 5 minutes, we might have a new leader in Boys 2 selected, and this can be now Aymar Urquiza. So all the Spanish people, I've seen many of you here with the flags cheering for your people. Be ready to cheer for Aymar here in the finish really soon. And on the same time, we have Atte Ikola in the finish in Boys 1 school. And he took the lead by 3 seconds ahead of Arvid Aronsson. In the second radio, he was 36 seconds ahead of Arvid Aronsson, so he did slightly slower last part, so the last 5 minutes he took slightly slower, but he's currently the first in Boys 1 school ahead of Arvid Aronsson by 3 seconds. And in Girls 2 school, we have in the radio control Anda Janmuktanev from Latvia, currently taking the second place but losing to the first only 3 seconds. So soon we can have a new leader here because she still stands a chance against the current leader in the finish. And the competitors who still haven't taken back your maps, the ones that you gave away in the finish area, you can come to the finish area and get your maps back. Then you can go and analyze with your coaches. And in the radio control in Boys 2 selected, we have Danilo Tvornikov currently taking the lead. Danilo Tvornikov from Ukraine taking the lead ahead of Aymar Urquiza by just 1 second. So nothing is sure in there yet. Anything can happen in the last 800 meters if the differences between the times are so short. So just a few seconds. In Girls 1 school, we have in the finish Kara Bradding from New Zealand, taking currently the third place, losing to the leader Aino Asklöf by 1 minute and 42 seconds. Boys 2 selected, we have a Scottish boy, Adam Barry, through the radio control with a third time and losing only 13 seconds to the leader, so he really stands a chance for beating the current leader as well. So in Boys 2 selected, we really wait for new best times in the next 5 minutes, and they're three fast times coming real soon. And Aymar Urquiza is in the finish in Boys 2 selected and taking second place at the moment, losing 3 seconds to David Rapotz from Austria, who is currently the leader in Boys 2 selected. And here really soon we still have Danilo Tvornikov and Adam Barry coming for the last around 800 meters, and they have the chance to beat David Rabot here in the finish as well. But Aymar Urquiza currently second in boys to selected. And in girls to school, we have Maria Feline Bisping in the finish from Austria, currently taking the third place, losing to the leader Polina Levchenko by 2 minutes and 28 seconds. In boys one school, we have a new leader in the first radio control. It's Maxim Omelchenko from Sweden. And he takes the lead by 1 minute and 8 seconds ahead of Atte Ikolam. And in the finish, we have Anda Jan Mukhtana from Latvia. Again, with a really good time, currently taking the lead ahead of Polina Levchenko by 1 minute and 10 seconds. So a really good run from the Latvian girl today. And I think this time, the time run by Anda Jan Mukhtana is the one that's going to stay in the top today. I'm pretty sure it's good enough to time to be somewhere in the top by the end of the day. In girls one selected, we have in the finish Aiga Irvebluma from Latvia with a second place, losing 33 seconds to Ebba Lindell from Sweden. And on the same time, in girls two school, we have through the radio control Teresa Monsberger with third place, losing only 3 seconds to the fastest time. So if she runs fast now, she can be faster than Anda Jan Mukhtana in the finish in girls two school. In boys one school, we have in the first radio a new third best time by Hector Sanchez from Spain, losing to the current leader there by 1 minute and 22 seconds. And on the same time, Thea Fagerström, this name we've heard already, is in the first radio with the best time and ahead of Ein Oskloff by 1 minute and 13 seconds. So really soon, in the next around 6 or 7 minutes, I think we expect a new leader in girls one school, and this will be Thea Fagerström if she doesn't do any weird things in the last part. And if you have finished already, make sure to take warm clothes really soon. It's just about 5 degrees here today, so I would be really happy if you wouldn't catch any cold here, and I would be really sad if you have to fall ill after this call. So please make sure to take warm clothes, and then you can come back and cheer for your friends. And now in the finishing girls to school, we have Olivia Power from New Zealand, currently taking the second place, 57 seconds behind Anda Janmuktane in girls to school. We have a new best time in girls one selected in the radio control. It's Luboslava Vesova from Slovakia, currently taking the lead in the radio control by 1 minute and 15 seconds ahead of Eppa Lindell. And we have a new second best time in boys one selected in first radio, and it's Hando Alman from Estonia going behind the current leader by 36 seconds, and the current leader is Francesco Mariani, who as well has the best time in the finish. And we have in the finish Teresa Monsberger from Austria, and she managed to, we said that she has the chance to get a faster time than Anda Janmuktane, and she is in the finish 5 seconds faster than the Latvian girl. So the new leader in girls' two school, Teresa Monsberger from Austria. And as well the new leader in boys' two selected in the finish, Max Möbius from England, takes the lead ahead of David Rapport by 15 seconds. And as well in boys' one school, in the second radio, Maxim Omelchenko is now there, and he's there with the fastest time ahead of Ate Ikola by 1 minute and 43 seconds. So in boys one school, I'm really sure there will be a new leader in the finish in the next 7 or 8 minutes, and it will be Maxim Omelchenko, because he has a really big lead ahead of the second place in the second radio, and it's not really difficult after that. In girls one school, there's Hanne Hilo from Finland in the radio control with the fastest time. And it's really by far the fastest now, ahead of even Thea Fagerström by 31 seconds. So Hanne Hilo from Finland in girls one school, the fastest in the radio control. And we have a new finisher in boys two school. It's Samuel Taylor Sinclair from New Zealand, who currently takes the third place behind Luke Clements from New Zealand by 5 minutes and 44 seconds. So the gap between the first and the third place in this class is really a massive one. And we have in the finish Thea Fagerström from Sweden taking the lead in girls one school by 1 minute and 22 seconds behind Aino Asklöf. But we do know that there is still Hanne Hilo from Finland coming, and she was faster than Thea by 31 seconds in the radio control, so she might stand a chance to be today faster than Thea. And now I managed to get Thea here in the Finnish area. It looks like a nice run from you today, but there's still a Finnish girl in the radio control 30 seconds faster than you. So where did those 30 seconds go to?
I did a little thing to a control, and well, it was pretty unnecessary. So it hasn't been a perfect race, but it's still like it went really fast, and my body felt better than I thought it would, so that was good.
Well, that's nice to hear that your body felt better, but did your mind feel better as well? Was it easy for you to do the route choices today?
Yeah, well, I don't know if I took the best route choices yet, but I made pretty quick decisions, so hopefully I won't lose too much time on those.
Yes, to me it looked like the choices to go around looked like a bit better today. But see, even the sun came out during our interview. So yes, I wish you a nice recovery now and get ready for the last race. And thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
So yes, even a bit of sun showed itself during the interview with Thea. And on the same time, we have a new leader in girls, one selected. It's Luboslava Vesova from Slovakia, taking the lead ahead of Eva Lindell by 1 minute and 37 seconds in girls, one selected. And on the same time, Spanish boy Hector Sanchez in Boys One School has reached the second radio with his second best time behind Maxim Momolchenko by 1 minute and 34 seconds. So Hector Sanchez, soon we expect him here in the finish as well, currently holding the second place in the second radio. And in the same class, really soon, Maxim Omelchenko from Sweden should arrive here with the best time. And we have Hanna Hilo here in the finish. Wow, she did a really nice last part as well, because in the radio control, the difference with Thea Fagerström was just 31 seconds, and now it's 58 seconds. So Hanna Hilo definitely managed to do a nice ending for the race as well, and takes the lead at the moment by far with the best time.
Can I have a few words with you?
Yes, so now here I managed to find Hanna Hilo, and you look like really happy with your race today. So was it a total success for you?
Yes, it was. And as the boys say, full speed, no mistakes.
That's really nice to hear. You look like really amazingly happy. How was the race for you 2 days ago? Not so good as today, or?
No, I missed the first control then, and I went the wrong path, but it was amazing.
But it's really nice to hear that today was like a perfect success for you, and I think it's going to be a really nice by the end of the day. So yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
It's always so nice to see people so happy with their race. It looks like Hanna Hilo made, I think, no mistakes today, and there was nothing to complain about. She was so confident about her race today, and there's a reason for that. She still holds the best time in the radio control. Well, there are still quite a few people to start in this class, but I'm pretty sure that her time is the one that will stay on the top of the leaderboard until the end of the day. And on the same time, Maxim Omelchenko has reached the finish with the best time by far. He's ahead of Ate Ikola by 2 minutes and 35 seconds. So Maxim Omelchenko from Sweden did a really amazing race today. And not only the beginning, but the whole race seems to have been a real success from him. There is still Julien Vuitton from France coming in this class, and he was behind Maxim with 19 seconds in the second radio. So maybe he still stands a chance. Depends if Maxim did any mistakes in the finish, before the finish. But yeah, both of them are doing really good. And in boys one selected, Alexander Gepler from Estonia came to the first radio control with a second best time behind the leader, just 23 seconds. It's a good run from Alexander today at the moment, but there are still the hardest parts to come in that class after this radio control, so it's early to say anything yet from the whole race. And in the same class, Hando Alman from Estonia, taking currently the third place in the second radio. And after that, it's easy until the end. So in the second radio, Hando Alman takes the third place and loses 59 seconds to the current leader, Francesco Mariani. In girls one selected, we have a new third best time in Finnish. It's Aija Denja Drezina from Latvia, losing to the leader at the moment by 2 minutes and 6 seconds. And as well, Hector Sanchez in the finish. Well, here the best time is from Maxim Omelchenko, as we told, but Hector Sanchez now took the second place, losing 2 minutes and 4 seconds to Maxim. So currently in the finish with a second place, Hector Sanchez from Spain. In boys to school, we have in the finish Fernando Martinez from Spain with a third best time, losing 2 minutes and 11 seconds to Luke Clements from New Zealand. And as well, Julian Vuitton, who we said that might have a chance to beat Maxim Omelchenko, but still took the second place, 5 seconds behind Maxim Omelchenko. So Julian Vuitton, second at the moment in boys one school, and losing 5 seconds to Maxim Omelchenko, but still with a really good time. And on the same time, Hando Alman from Estonia in the finish, currently taking third place in boys one selected, losing to Francesco Mariani with 1 minute and 31 seconds. So Hando Alman, third best time in boys one selected at the moment in the finish. leidsin üles Hando Almani, räägiksin paar sõna siia vahele ka eesti keeles. Hando, tundub, et täna oli täitsa hea jooks, aga see minut 30 siiski kuskile veel jäi, mis on siin liidriga vahet, et kas see jäi täna jooksu taha või jäi see tehnilise taha või oli liiga võsane või liiga mägine?
Kuna üleile tavarajal väga jooks ei õnnestunud ja võtsin liiga palju otse teie valiku mitte ringi minnes, täna just üritasin võtta jooksu rahulikult, teha kindlemad teie valikud, pigem ringi kui otsa oli võsa, aga lõpupoole oli paar päris rasket tõusu reesmikel ja siis oli jooksu või raskus ja tundsin, et sinna võiski minna päris palju aega jooksuraha. Aga muidu oli tehniliselt täna päris puhas sooritus.
Mulle tundub igatahes, et igati õiged valikud, see ringi valik siin metsas tundub selgelt kiirem ja õigem ja siuke ennast säästav, nii et mulle tundub, et täna tuli sul igati välja nii nagu plaanitud, nii et palju õnne ja edu ka järgmiseks jooksuks.
Aitäh.
Aitäh. So we spoke with Hando Alman, who currently holds the third place in Boys 1 Selected, and he said that his run failed a bit 2 days ago because he tried to go through much straight through the forest, and today he took it more secure and tried to really make it a race that is a success. And he said he managed to do that, but it was just tough on the last hills, and that's where he lost some time. But what we take from here is that in this forest, I think it's really more smart to take a bit round choices, because it is a lot of tiny forest tracks in here and a lot of tiny roads for skiing, since it's a skiing resort for cross country. And yes, I think it is faster and better actually to run a bit around and not through the forest. As you can see from the screen, it can be really slow to run through the forest, and when you have to run over the fallen trees, it can be really exhausting as well. And it's exhausting already due to the hills, so it can be really faster to take these round route choices today, and of course more secure, since it's really tricky to find the controls if you try to go straight through the forest. So again, a little announcement for the information. I heard that there is two teams who are staying in a accommodation place called Marguse. And those two teams, I suppose it's Latvia and Turkey, you are not allowed to, also Slovenia too, as I've heard. Those teams, you're not allowed to walk to that place because it's on the forbidden area, and you will be taken there by car, by the organizers, and this car will be close to the food area here. I just heard from one of the organizers that he will come close to the food area and he will take you there with a car because you're not allowed to walk through the competition terrain to get to your accommodation. So please use this car service provided by the organizers and don't walk through the forbidden area. Thank you. And about the results as well, we have a new leader in Girls One selected in the radio control. It's Maria Hoskari from Finland. And she takes the lead ahead of Lubaslava Vesova by 31 seconds in the radio control. So she stands a chance to get the fastest time in the finish at the moment. Maria Hoskari from Finland. And as well in first radio and the only radio control in boys two school, we have Angus Ivory from Scotland with a third best time at the moment, losing 53 seconds to the leader. So Angus Ivory can make another good run here. He did a really good run 2 days ago already, so I believe he's able to do another one here today. And now Angus Ivory is in finish. Angus Ivory from Scotland taking the third place in boys' two school, losing by 24 seconds to the best time at the moment, who is Luke Clements from New Zealand. And now we have a new time in girls' two school in the radio control. It's Sophia Toews from New Zealand taking the best time in the radio control and leading by more than 1 minute ahead the others. So soon in the finish in girls two school, we might get a new leader from New Zealand, Sophia Toews. And in girls one selected, new leader in the finish, Maria Hoskari, 7 seconds ahead of Lubaslava Vesova. So she did a slightly slower ending part, but still she's the leader in the finish in girls one selected, Maria Hoskari from Finland. And in girls two school, we have a new leader in the radio control from Austria, Flora Eichmüller. and taking the lead ahead of Sophia Toews by 30 seconds in the radio control. So definitely soon in Girls 2 school we'll have new best times and maybe even two of them. And the new third best time in Girls 2 School, Irina Rakhmankulova from Russia, losing 32 seconds to the first one. So she now has a third best time in there. And Judith Ravel from Spain in Girls 2 selected with a best time ahead of another Spanish girl, Marta Martinez, by 9 seconds. So two best times at the moment from Spain in Girls 2 selected. And I will repeat the announcement with a little change now. So those three national teams who are staying in Margose Hotel, so Margose accommodation place, if you are staying there, I think it was Turkey, Latvia, and then Slovenia, you are not allowed to walk there because you will have to walk through the competition terrain. So you're not allowed to walk there, and the organizers will take you there by car, so you wouldn't have to wait here and get frozen. And for that, you should go to the place where's information and registration. So beforehand, I told you to go to near to the food area, but the new information is that you should go to the information and registration room, so it's a little warmer to wait for the car. So if you're staying in Margose accommodation, I think it's Latvia, Slovenia, and Turkish team, then you should go to the information, and from there the car will take you to your accommodation. You are not allowed to walk in there through the competition area. And in Girls 2 School, we have a new leader in the finish, Sophia Toews from New Zealand. Really soon, though, we have Floria Eichmüller there who might beat Sophia's time. But at the moment, the best time in there is Sophia Toews from New Zealand. In Girls 1 School, we have through the radio control Marta Ljungberg from Sweden with the third best time. 2 days ago, she was on the podium as well. At the moment, she's losing to the first time in the radio control by 42 seconds. So I think she still stands a chance to be in the top six today as well. There's quite many people still to come, but I know that the times that are there at the moment in the finish are already the really good ones. And in Girls 1 selected, we have a new leader in the radio. It's from Austria, Maya Demeyer-Kastner, taking the lead by 19 seconds ahead of Maria Hoskare. So Austria, Maya Demeyer-Kastner in the radio, taking the best time at the moment. From Lithuania, Aistė Dementavičiūtė in the radio control with the third best time, losing 42 seconds to Flora Eichmüller in the radio control. So soon we will expect a Lithuanian girl in the finish as well. And now Flora Eichmüller is in finish and she took the very best time now here. She's ahead of Sophia Toews by 32 seconds. So Flora Eichmüller from Austria taking the lead in girls to school. And on the same time, we have a new best time in girls one selected in the radio control, Sophia Wigler from Sweden. And she is ahead of Maya Kastner by 19 seconds. So Sophia Wigler making a really good time at the moment in the radio control. And this is the only radio control in this track. And from there to finish is just about 5 minutes. So really soon we expect new leaders in girls one selected. And from Estonia, Brigitte Banker making yet another good run in girls 2 selected. Currently the best time in the radio control. Brigitte Banker from Estonia in girls 2 selected. The best time in the radio control. And this is by 51 seconds ahead of Marta Martinez in this radio. So she's doing a really good run today. And we expect her in the finish in about 6 or 7 minutes. So just a bit left to run for Brigitte Banker today. In boys one selected, we have a local boy, Kustu Gunapas, third place at the moment in the first radio control in boys one selected, behind the leader by 32 seconds, Kustu Gunapas from Estonia. And in the finishing girls one selected, we have Maya Timea Kastner with the best time from Austria, girls one selected. And she goes ahead of Maria Hoskari by 35 seconds in the finish. It's a really good run from the Austrian girl today, Maya Timea Kastner. But there is still Sofia Wigler from Sweden to come. The difference in the radio control was just 19 seconds. So it's going to be tight in the finish today. So in boys to school, we haven't finished. Elias Monsberger from Austria taking the third place, 15 seconds behind Luke Clements from New Zealand. So Elias Monsberger currently on the third place in boys to school. And in girls one selected in the finish we have Sofia Wigler from Sweden with the best time, just 1 second ahead of Maja Dimmer-Kastner from Austria. It was really tight in this class today. So Sofia Wigler did a slightly slower ending, but nevertheless, she is the new leader now, taking the lead just by 1 second in the finish. So here with me, Sofia Wigler now. Congratulations, just the lead by 1 second. Did you take it slow in the end because you lost 18 seconds in the after the last radio control, which is in the sixth control? So did you take it slow after that, or just steadily to the end and just trying to make it sure?
I thought I took a road choice straight through the green area. I think I lost some time of that, I didn't take it slower, I think.
Did you make any mistakes today at all? Because your time is really good. It can be that you had a really clean race.
I didn't make so much mistakes, I think. One little direction mistake at some control, but not so much, no.
It looks like a really amazing race from you, so congratulations for that, and thank you.
Thank you.
And we have in the finish Brigitte Banker from Estonia with the very best time and even 1 minute and 37 seconds ahead of Spanish girl Judith Ravel. So we'll see if we can get a few words from Brigitte Banker as well. Ja teen vahelduseks ühe intervju jälle eesti keeles. Brigitte Banker tundub, et täna jällegi tõeliselt hea ajaga siia finishisse jõudnud. Kuidas siis tänane jooks oli? Kas kõik sujus või oli ka miskit, mida saaks veel paremini teha?
Sujus kindlasti kuskil oleks saanud natuke paremini teha, ma arvan.
Kas oleks saanud paremini jooksukiiruse või nüüd teevalikute mõttes?
Teevalikud ja võib-olla mõnes kohas jooksukiirus.
Ja selge, aitäh! Sul on veel siin üks võistluspäev jäänud, kus on võimalik veel paremaid valikuid teha ja veel kiiremini joos.
Jah.
Aitäh! So Brigitte Banker was this from Estonia, and she is by far with the best time in the finish at the moment from girls to selected. And we have a new best time in the second radio in Boys One School, and that time is really good. It's from Olof Lundgren from Sweden. And he now stands the chance to beat Maxim Omelchenko in the finish. The difference is just 8 seconds, so Olof has to run really fast for the last part of the track in order to be the fastest one in the finish. And in Boys 2 School, we have a new best time in the radio control. It's a Latvian boy, Audris Odo Vitolins, and takes the lead by 7 seconds in this radio control. So if Audris now comes really fast for the last part, then he stands the chance to go ahead of Luke Clements, who has been on top of the list now for quite a while already. And we have a new second best time in Girls One Selected, or you might even call it first best, because Olha Hupalo from Ukraine is with the very same time as Sofia Wigler in the radio control. So Olha Hupalo from Ukraine is going to be really tight in the finish now, if she is able to beat Sofia or not. And we have him finished, Audrius Odovitalins from Latvia, and he was able to beat Luke Clements in the finish. Audrius Odovitalins, with the best time in Boys 2 School, takes the lead by 37 seconds at the moment in the finish. So really good run from the Latvian boy. And in Girls 2 School, Emma Havlikova from Slovakia, taking currently the second place Girls to School behind Flora Eichmüller by 25 seconds. So Emma Havlikova from Slovakia taking the second place. She did a really good fast run in the last part. She took back from the leader about 40 seconds just with the last part of the race. So yeah, she ran really fast as well. In boys, one selected. We have a new third best time in the first radio control. It's Henrik Petrisi from Sweden behind the leader in the first radio with 24 seconds. We have a new leader in the finish in girls' school, Agnese Janmukhtane, taking the lead by 1 minute and 22 seconds ahead of Laura Eigmüller. Amazing. And in boys 2 selected, Olle Ilmariama from Estonia took the lead by 2 minutes ahead of the second place. Olle Ilmariama in boys 2 selected with the very best time in the finish at the moment. I'll see if I get a few words with him as well. I know that 2 days ago he was a bit disappointed with a 2 minute mistake, but still, despite that, had a third place. No nii, Olle Ilmar, üleeile sa olid veidi siin hädas, et 2 minutit läks vea peale, 2 minutit jooksu peale. Hetkel on sul pikalt parim aeg, et kas täna siis said need vead välditud ja jooks oli vaigas?
Vigasid täna sisse ei tund, jah. Võibolla üks valik läks nii, et jooks muidugi võssa kinni ennast, aga muidu jooks oli puhas ja füüsiliselt üritasin siis nii kõik anda, et teadsin, et võibolla tuleb puhta jooks ja siis on lootust jälle medali kolmikusse siis.
Nii et täna kõik õnnestus ja jooks klappis ja tuli selliselt nagu tulema peabki ja jääd ise igati rahule.
Ja võib küll nii jälle, jah, et üpriski 100% sooritus.
Väga hea, super! Palju õnne sulle ja aitäh!
Aitäh!
So this was Estonian boy Olle Ilmariama, who is currently the leader in boys 2 selected with a margin of 2 minutes. And 2 days ago, he said he made a 2 minute mistake and the running wasn't quite as it should be. But now he said he managed to give 100% of him and he's really satisfied and happy with the race of today. No mistakes and it really worked out really good. And on the same time, we have a new third best in girls one selected. Loreli Kurvel from Estonia goes behind Sofia Wiegler by 16 seconds in the finish. So new third best time in girls one selected, Loreli Kurvel from Estonia. And on the same time in boys one selected, Adam Jonas, who was the winner 2 days ago, now is in the second radio with a third best time, 40 seconds behind the leader Francesco Mariani. So Adam Jonas today probably has made some mistakes, but still stands a chance to be somewhere near the top. But probably not the first one, because 40 seconds is a bit too much to beat, but who knows? And on the same time, in the same class, in boys one selected, Davis Solmanis from Latvia takes the lead in the first radio control and he takes the lead by 9 seconds ahead of Francesco Mariani from Italy. So Davis Solmanis from Latvia, currently the leader in the first radio in boys one selected. And again, a girl who did a really good run 2 days ago, Emma Eriksson from Sweden. A girls one school currently in the radio control takes the second place, 26 seconds behind the current leader, Hanne Hilo. 26 seconds here might be a bit too much to beat because Hanne Hilo said that she wasn't much struggling with the running. But who knows? So Emma Eriksson currently on the second place in the radio control. And a girl who is the only one who said that it was really easy for her to run the hills 2 days ago. Zara Stewart from New Zealand takes the lead in the radio control. And she takes the lead again by a really massive margin of more than a minute. So Zara Stewart, soon we expect to see her in the finish with the best time. She's yet again making an amazing run. On the same time in the finish, Henrik Petrisi from Sweden takes currently the second place in boys one selected. 1 minute and 10 seconds behind the leader Francesco Mariani. So Henrik Petrisi from Sweden going to the second place. And on the same time in boys two school, we have Kaapo Lehtonen, who made a really good run 2 days ago as well. Kaapo Lehtonen takes the lead in the radio control at the moment in boys two school, 16 seconds ahead of Audrios Odovitolins. And in the finish we have Adam Jonas from Slovakia, and now taking the second place. So probably today he made a few mistakes because he is able to run fast, as we saw 2 days ago. But second place is good as well. 30 seconds behind the first, Francesco Mariani from Italy. In boys two selected, Artur Gutovi from Ukraine in the finish with the third best time at the moment, losing 1 minute and 34 seconds to the Estonian boy Olle Ilmariama. In girls two selected, where the current leader is Brigitte Banker, we have Egan Müller through the radio control and losing to Brigitte just by 6 seconds. So Egan Müller from Poland stands a chance today to be the fastest in girls two selected. On the same time in girls two selected, we have Maria Eller with the fifth best time in the radio control. So today she probably has made some mistakes because 2 days ago she had the second place. At the moment she loses by 2 minutes and 9 seconds to Brigitte Banker in the radio control and currently holds a fifth place. And in this class, we pretty soon actually have the last starters. So in just 8 minutes, the last girl in this class will start. So in about half an hour, we will have the final results there. And on the same time, James Bailey from England takes the second place in boys one selected, losing just with 30 seconds to Francesco Mariani. And actually he shares the second and third place with Adam Jonas. So James Bailey from England. And in the finish, we have Emma Eriksson from Sweden on the second place, losing 7 seconds to Hanna Hilo. Just 7 seconds. She managed to take back 19 seconds with the last short part of the race, but it wasn't enough today. So first place at the moment in girls one school, Hanna Hilo. Second, Emma Eriksson, losing 7 seconds. And third is Marta Ljungberg, losing 50 seconds. Again, the Swedish girls have done amazing runs in there, but today Hanna Hilo was better. And Zara Stewart, the fast girl who was by far the best 2 days ago, is leading girls to school at the moment in the finish by a minute and 34 seconds. Zara Stewart, wow, you did an amazing race. And on the same time in boys to school, there is Kaapo Lehtonen, who is the fastest in the finish at the moment. 16 seconds of Audrius Odovitolins. So Kaapo Lehtonen taking the lead in boys to school. And I will see if I will find Zara on the meanwhile. I managed to find Zara Stewart again. And wow, how are you doing it? How do you manage to be the best on 2 days and by so big margin? Is it really that easy for you?
Well, I think I found today a bit harder because I'm a bit run down, a bit tired, and it was very cold out there, but it was pretty clean run, so I'm pretty happy with it.
And is it again today that way, that it was the hilly parts were easy for you? Because to be honest, 2 days ago you were the only one who said it was easy.
There weren't as many hills as the long, which I found a bit easier, but the ones that were there, which were quite big, we had to climb some pretty steep hills, so that was quite hard, but apart from that, it was pretty good.
Well, it's nice to hear that for someone it's easy, and it's nice to hear that at least something was hard for you. Otherwise, I would feel bad for myself and for the others. But yeah, congratulations for the amazing run, then. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
So Zara Stewart, yes, well, one day I want to be as strong of a runner as she is. I want to have it in the same way that I finish, I just smile and I say like, yeah, not a big deal. There was just one hill that was slightly hard, but everything else was totally doable. And on the same time, Latvian boy Davis Solmanis in the second radio taking the lead ahead of Francesco Mariani. And now this boy, Davis Solmanis from Latvia, is the one who really stands a chance to beat the current leader who's been standing there for a long time. He's faster than Francesco in the second radio by 41 seconds. So this should be pretty safe lead in order to actually beat Francesco in the finish. And Tamara Miklušová from Slovakia, currently running the best time in the radio control in girls one selected. So Tamara Miklušová taking the lead in the radio control by 17 seconds. So there is some really fast Slovakian girl coming towards the finish soon. And at the same time, we had finishing Maria Eller from Estonia taking the fifth place currently in curls to select it. And in this class, pretty soon the results should be final. So I think she will stay at least in top 10 today and maybe even top 6. So Maria Eller currently fifth in the finishing girls to select it. In girls to school, already everybody has started. The last one to start was around 4 minutes ago. So pretty soon, in about 15 minutes, the top 6 of girls to school should be finalized. In boys one selected, there is a new second best time in the second radio. Domen Gavčík from Slovakia, losing 31 seconds to the best one in the second radio control. So pretty soon we expect the leaderboard of boys one selected to change, because we're expecting Latvian boy Davis Solmanis to take the lead, and we expect Slovakian boy Domen taking the second place in there. Evan Musgrave from Scotland has the radio control in boys 2 selected with the second best time, losing 59 seconds to the first Ole Ilmar Jama there. In this class, almost everybody has soon started. No, everybody has already started, so the results should be really final really soon, in less than 20 minutes. So Ole Ilmar Jama really made a good race today and in the lead by far at the moment in boys 2 selected. So Davis Solmanis from Latvia now in the finish with the best time. So finally someone to beat the Italian boy Francesco Mariani, who's been there in the lead for a long time already, because he started in the beginning. So Davis Solmanis pushes Francesco Mariani to the second place in boys one selected. And Domen Kovčić from Slovenia, still yet to come there. So he has the chance to take the second place in boys one selected. And on the same time, Melina Lahtenberger, who did a really good run 2 days ago, is doing it again. She is with the very best time in the first radio in girls one school, ahead of Hanne Hilo by 39 seconds. So Melina Lahtenberger stands a chance today to beat the other Finnish girl and become the first in the finish. And now there is a threat for Olla Ilmariama. In the radio control, there is Emis Lazdans from Latvia, and he's faster than Olla Ilmar by 27 seconds in the radio control. So he is probably the only one at the moment to actually able to beat Olla Ilmar in the finish in boys two selected. And there's David Borg from Sweden with the same time as Olof Lundgren in the first radio in boys one school. So David Borg from Sweden, who is running as fast as Olof Lundgren in boys one school, so taking the lead and sharing the second place. And on the same time, in girls one selected from Slovakia, Tamara Miklušová as a leader in the finish, ahead of Sofia Vigle by 43 seconds. So amazing run by Tamara Miklušová, and she currently holds the very best time in the radio control as well. So she now still has to wait less than half an hour to be sure if she is the winner today or not. And on the same time, we have a new third best time in girls two school, Svetlana Baryshnikova from Russia, losing to Zara Stewart by 2 minutes and 38 seconds. So a new third best time in girls two selected. And girls one selected, we have a new leader in the radio, Hanna Lundberg. She did a really good run 2 days ago as well, so I think she is able to beat the best ones in here now today. She is faster than Tamara Miklušová just by 4 seconds. So it's going to be really tight to finish to see who is faster today. So Hanna Lundberg at the moment with the fastest time in the radio control. Girls one selected. And on the same time, we have in finish Evan Musgrave from boys two selected with a third best time, losing to Olla Ilmar by 1 minute and 24 seconds. So really soon the results in this class should be final. And now we have the best time in there. Emils Lazdans from Latvia pushing Olla Ilmar to the second place. Emils Lazdans today with the best time in boys two selected, just 15 seconds faster than Olla Ilmar. And now these results should be final. The fastest in boys two selected today, Emis Lazdans from Latvia. Second, Olla Ilmariama from Estonia. Third, Mateo Rodriguez from Spain. And fourth, Evan Musgrave from Scotland. And now, in boys one selected, we have a new second best time in the second radio. It's Edmund Grierson, who did a good run 2 days ago as well. And he loses to the best time there just by 4 seconds. So Edmund really stands a chance today to run the fastest time in boys one selected. And in the finish we have Melina Lahtenberger from Finland with the fastest time, pushing another Finnish girl, Hanna Hilo, to the second place. So Melina Lahtenberg yet again with an amazing run and taking the best place in girls one school by 57 seconds. Crazy run from today from Melina. The boys one selected at the moment, we are waiting the Finnish Edmund Grierson, who has the chance to beat Davis Solmanis. But there, among the last starters, we still had Felix Silver, who can be the one who's faster than others, and Ilian Angeli, who were the ones doing really good runs 2 days ago. But at least at the moment, it seems that neither of them has passed the first radio, and that actually should be a time for them to pass this radio control already if they want to be faster than the leaders today. So at the moment it seems like Edmund Pearson is really the only one who's still able to threaten Davis Solmanis' leading position. And in girls one selected, Hanna Lundberg, amazing, taking the lead by 18 seconds ahead of Tamara Miklusha. So now we have a new best time in girls, one selected in the finish by Hanna Lundberg. And we have a new leader in the second radio in boys one school. It's David Borg from Sweden, and taking the lead by 38 seconds ahead of Olof Lundgren. So David Borg really making a good run at the moment. We expect him in the finish really soon, in the next less than 5 minutes. And Edmund Grierson is now in the finish and was not able to beat Davis Solmanis, taking the second place at the moment, losing 5 seconds to the first one. So Edmund Grierson taking second place at the moment in boys one selected. And those three teams who are staying in Marguse accommodation, if I remember correctly, it was Latvia, Turkey and Slovenia, you are not allowed to go to the Marguse accommodation on foot, because then you will have to go through the forbidden competition area. You will be taken there by cars, by the organizers. For that you have to go to the information or registration room. And from there, you can find out who will take you with the cars to your accommodation place. So please do not go on foot, because you would have to pass forbidden area for that. And this is strictly not allowed. So the only one in boys one selected who still stands a chance to have a change in a top six is Florencio Garcia from Spain. He was in the second radio with the fifth best time, losing 1 minute and 3 seconds to the winner, with the current leader, Davi Solmanis. So the only one who's probably able to change the top six in boys one selected is Florencio Garcia. At the moment, the top three there is Davi Solmanis from Latvia, Edmund Grierson from England, and Francesco Mariani from Italy. And it looks like the results of the top six of the girls to school, or at least top three, is now clear. So I think this is not going to change. In girls to school, the winner of today is again Zara Stewart. And second, Agnese Jan-Mukhtana. And third, Svetlana Burushnikova from Russia. So Sarah Stewart from New Zealand, Agnesa Jan-Mukhtana from Latvia, and Svetlana Burushnikova from Russia. In girls to school, the top three of today. And this should be a final now. And I think the results of boys to selected their final as well. The first is Emils Lastans from Latvia, second Olla Ilmariama from Estonia, and third Mateo Rodriguez from Spain. And we now have a new leader in boys to school in the radio control, Ewan Triner, who was with really good time 2 days ago as well. He's currently with the fastest time in the radio control and ahead of Kaapo Lehtonen by 27 seconds. And from there to finish, it's less than 5 minutes, so soon we might have a new leader in boys to school, and this leader can be from England. And at the same time, we have a new leader in boys one school, David Borg from Sweden. And three best times in boys one school are at the moment from Sweden. Wow, crazy. David Borg, the leader at the moment, second at the moment, Olof Lundgren, and third at the moment, Maxim Omelchenko in boys one school. So I found the current leader of the boys one school, David Borg, and I'm going to have a few words with him now. So David, best time at the moment, congratulations. Was it the perfect run for you today?
Almost. I made a small mistake in the end, but I'm overall pretty satisfied with my race today.
And how was the running part? I've heard from people that it was really tough to go straight through the green area today. Did you struggle with that, or was it easy for you?
Yeah, I tried to use the paths as much as I could, and yeah, I ran a lot of around, and I think that was good today.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's the winning tactic today, to actually run around. So congratulations for your good run, and good luck for the last day of the competition tomorrow.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. We have a new leader in the radio in Girls One Selected, Elsa Kuse from Latvia, taking the lead in the radio control at the moment, and just 6 seconds ahead of Hanna Lundberg. And in the finish, we have Ewan Triner with the best time in Boys 2 school. There's not many people who can still beat today Ewan's time. Ewan Triner with the very best time ahead of Kaapo Lehtonen by 42 seconds. And that's a big gap. It's a really nice run from him today. So at the same time, I think in Girls 2 Selected, the results look like kind of final as well. I don't see anybody who can anymore threaten the top three. And the winner there today is Brigitte Banker from Estonia. The second is Iga Müller from Poland, losing just by 6 seconds to Brigitte Banker. And the third is Judith Ravel from Spain, losing 1 minute and 37 seconds to Brigitte. And really soon it's going to get interesting as we wait to finish. Elsa Kuse from Latvia, who is maybe the only one who still stands a chance to beat today's leader, Hanna Lundberg, in the finish. The gap was just 6 seconds. And the gap with the third place, Tamara Miklusho, is just 11 seconds. So the top three in Girls 1 Selected will be really, really tight today. And in Boys 2 school, we have a new third best time in the finish. Joel Putsch from Austria going third in the finish, losing 51 seconds to Ewan Triner. And we have a new leader in Girls 1 Selected. Elsa Kuse from Latvia managed to be faster than Hanna Lundberg by just 4 seconds. So Elsa Kuse taking the lead in Girls 1 Selected today in the finish. And I think it's hard for anybody to beat her time now anymore today. So congratulations, Elsa Kuse. You for sure are staying in the top three, but I think the first place is yours today. And at the same time, French girls, Cécile Calendry in the finish. So the second place today, 50 seconds behind Melina Lachtenberg. There's still quite a few people who are able to beat their time today, as the last one started just 1 minute ago, and the last one to start is Hilda Holmqvist Johansson, who did a good run 2 days ago, so she still can beat their time. So Cécile Calendry in the finish from France, taking the second place at the moment. And on the same time, The French boy, Mile Heritier, who did a good run 2 days ago, is through the first radio with the third best time, losing just 16 seconds to the first time in the first radio. But in this class, the last ones still are yet to start, so there is nothing final yet. And the results look quite final as well in the, at least for the top three in boys to school. I think there is not much going to change anymore for the top three. And the first one today is Ewan Triner from England. Second is Kaapo Lehtonen from Finland. And third is Joel Putsch from Austria. The results should be final as well in boys two selected. For the first is Emil Lastans, Latvia. The second is Olail Mariama, Estonia. And third, Mateo Rodriguez from Spain. And as well for boys one selected, where the first is Davis Solmanis from Latvia. Second, Edmund Grierson from England. And third, Francesco Mariani from Italy. And we now have a new leader in the first radio control of Boys One School. Axel Elmblad from Sweden taking the lead in the first radio control ahead of David Borg and Olof Lundgren by 20 seconds. So Axel Elmblad doing a really fast run today. Well, if he manages to beat the top runners of today, then it looks like the four best times are by Swedish runners, which is crazy. But there is still Mile Heritier from France as well, who can interfere in the top three today. In Girls One School, the current leaderboard says that the first is Melina Lahtenberger, second is Cecile Calandry, and third is Hanna Hilo. But here, the results still can change because the last ones to go were 6 minutes ago, and there were really strong girls still going. So nothing is final yet in Girls One School. In Girls One Selected, I think nobody is anymore able to beat the top three, so this looks quite final to me. First one is Elsa Kuse from Latvia. Second is Hanna Lundberg from Sweden, losing just 4 seconds to the first one. And third is Tamara Miklusova from Slovakia, losing 22 seconds to Latvian girl Elsa Kuse. And the results look like final in the girls two school, where everybody is out of the forest. The first one, Zara Stewart, the fast girl, ahead of the second one by 1 minute and 34 seconds. The second in girls to school is Agnesa Janmuktane from Latvia. And third is Svetlana Burishnikova from Russia. And the results look like final as well in girls to select it. The first one is Brigitte Banker from Estonia, second is Iga Müller from Poland, and third is Judith Ravel from Spain. So there's not many classes where the results are still not yet clear. For boys one school, there is still a lot that can happen. And for girls one school, there is still a bit that can happen. So we're just waiting for these two classes to be with final results. We have Maëlle Héritier from France for the second radio control with the third best time, losing just 44 seconds to David Borg from Sweden. So Maëlle Héritier through the second radio with the third best time in boys one school. I think he still stands a chance to get the second place because he's really close to Olof Ljunggren's time. So it's going to be really tight in this top three now in the finish. He should be here in less than 5 minutes. We expect Maëlle Héritier to be in the finish in boys one school. So really soon, we should get to know if Hilda Holmqvist Johansson manages to do yet another good run. If she wants to beat Melina Lahtenberg today, she should be in the radio control in the next 2 or 3 minutes. And Axel Elmblad now in the second radio control with the very best time ahead of David Borg by 33 seconds. So Axel Elmblad making an amazingly good run in boys one school, holding the best time in the second radio control, and from there to finish is just about 5 minutes to come. So really soon we can have a new leader in boys one school. Thank you. And now, the one that we were waiting for, if she's able to beat other girls' time in Girls One School. Well, she wasn't the fastest, but she has the second best time. Hilda Holmqvist Johansson from Sweden, through the radio control, with the second best time, losing 22 seconds to Melina Lachtenberger at the moment. So she stands the chance to interfere with the top three today. Hilda Holmqvist Johansson. And now we have in the finish, Maël Héritier from France, the Boys One School. And in the finish, he's with the fifth time. So I think he must have had some struggles in the last part of the track because he was a bit faster beforehand. But fifth best time is really a nice time for Maël Héritier from France in Boys One School. And I suppose in Girls One School there is only one girl who is able to make a change in the top three, and this one girl is Hilda Holmqvist Johansson, who should be here in the finish in just a few minutes. And in Boys One School we wait for Axel Elmblad, who's done a really amazing run and probably is going to be the fastest here today. And now he's here, Axel Elmblad from Sweden, taking the lead and very best place in Boys One School. With a very big margin, 57 seconds ahead of David Borg in Boys One School. Axel Elmblad, the very best time of today in Boys One School. And it's going to be really hard if anybody wants to beat his time. Let's see if we can have a few words with him. So Axel Elmblad, really amazing time for you today. So was this a clear and perfect race for you?
Not really. I made some small mistakes and I don't know if I could do it. Best route choices.
But was it like an easy run for you? So it looks like you went really, really fast because you have such an amazing time today. It's going to be really difficult for anyone to beat you.
Yeah, I tried to push really hard from the beginning to the end.
It's really nice and congratulations for the really good run.
Thank you very much.
So Axel Elmblad, it's going to be hard for anybody to be faster than this boy today. And while we had a few words with him, Hilda Holmqvist Johansson finished on the second place. Hilda Holmqvist Johansson from Sweden taking the second place today in Girls One School. And it looks like there is nobody who can be faster than the top three today anymore in this class. So the top three Girls One School, Melina Lahtenberger from Finland, Hilda Holmqvist Johansson from Sweden, and Cecile Calendry from France. So now the only class where it's not clear yet who will be the top three of today is Boys One School, and they're the last ones to start, still are yet to go. The last one to start today there is Michelle Cooper from New Zealand, and he starts in 2 minutes. And the best time there today is 19 minutes and 15 seconds. So in about 21 minutes, has to be totally clear who's the top three in Boys One School as well. And in all the other classes, it's pretty clear already. So soon enough it should be clear about Boys One School as well. That's still yet the last class where the top three is not totally secured yet, but I don't actually see anybody beating their times today anymore at the moment. So I'm not 100% sure, but quite sure that this is how the top three will stay today, and this will be a Swedish top three for this class. Axel Elmblad from Sweden, David Borg from Sweden, and Olof Lundgren from Sweden. The Swedish boys really did a clean job in Boys One School today. So yes, now it looks pretty clear that there is nobody who can beat Boys One School's top three or maybe even top six. Well, top six can be. That is a so-so because there is Mitchell Cooper from New Zealand who in the first radio loses by 2 minutes and 8 seconds, but it looks like it's a bit too much. If he does a perfect run after that, then there is a chance for the top six, but no chance for top three, I would say. And there is the Swedish trio, which I said about before, Axel Elmblad, David Borg, and Olof Lundgren.
Thank you. me.
Dini. Dini je mu prstavno. Čekaj, a vidiš da je to...
O, ja je, neni. Ne, neni. Škoda. A bolo ovo.
Zdaj se gra na sveja.
Gre na slovensko dostavo. Pijeva. Я вижу.
And here a little announcement for the coaches, the ones who want to go and try how their tracks were and want to see how good you would be orienteering these same tracks as the competitors did today. You can now go to start. So coaches, you can go to start to try out the orienteering tracks of today. And the start is open until 5:15 p.m. So from now until 5:15 p.m. is your chance to try out the orienteering tracks that the competitors were running today. Good luck to you with that, and I hope you enjoy these middle distance courses here in Otapää.